Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 2 rolls on Marvel Legends time with Titus Build-A-Figure. This time we're looking at Drax, a repaint and reissue of the figure. This is just over 6 inches tall. Let's go look at the packaging, then we'll go on. I should have mentioned the Star-Lord's review. It's got the Guardians on the background of the box, which looks really good. As usual, it seems John Tyler Christopher is on the artwork for the packaging. Beautifully done, as usual. Looks great. Looks almost right out of the movie. Might well be, but I think it's his artwork. And on the back of the packaging, there's all the figures that if you put them together will build Titus, and we'll review all of those and put Titus at the very end. Now there is Drax and some yada yada if you want to read it, and some nice glam art short work on the back of the package. Let's spin around again and we'll get a look at Drax. There's a little bit of Drax from the back, and you'll see he has a twin brother. And this is his brother from the previous year, so yes, it's the previous couple of years. Slight differences in this figure, we'll go through them in just a minute, but let's get a look at the figure if you're brand new to it. He also comes with a gigantic ass weapon, which I think we briefly see in the trailer. I haven't yet had a chance to really examine the trailer frame by frame to see it, but he does have a gun at one point, and I mean, this thing is absolutely huge. It looks in some ways familiar to me that we've had it before, but I don't know where. He kind of holds it and he doesn't hold it very well because his hands are really the same from the previous release for knives. But I'll muck around with it. But let me know if you've had some problems or you're picking this figure up if you want to use this weapon or not. But Drax looks pretty good. He's got some nice details on him. He has a brand new head sculpt this year and it's way more accurate than it was previous year. So we do get some nice touches. One is his skin tones, I guess, a little bit closer to what it is in the movie. The silver is applied in a little more places, particularly on the front of the boots, which I don't think we had. We'll compare in just a second and let you see. And that's pretty much it. It's really a repackaged, slight repaint. It's the same figure all over, but just slightly different. The weapons seem to have lost, they're a different plastic, it seems, and a lot less better looking. We'll look at those in just a second, and then we'll talk about articulation. So, compared to last year's, what things did we have then that we don't have now? So, what we did have back then was the colour wasn't so great, but it did have a shine to the body, so that was a bit of a negative, I guess. The knives, as I mentioned, have a much more knife-like colour. There's a little bit of wash almost on them, whereas these ones here, you can see, it's a very dull, very flat. They may be more accurate, but I prefer the more knife-like. It looked more like a knife. The green looks much better. The transfers are exactly the same, but the paint used on this one is shiny, and in this one it's dull. I guess that's more screen accurate? I don't know. So Drax still decides it's too warm to wear a jacket, and he just goes as he is. So exact same figure, only head sculpt. That's it. That's all you're getting. There's a difference. And I correct myself, the boots did have that kind of silver touch on the front of the boots there. But that's it, there's nothing really different about this figure. Still a good figure nonetheless. Head sculpt there looks pretty damn good, as I mentioned. And articulated on that ball joint allows you to go that far back and about that far forward. So you get plenty of movement on there. Ball joint with a hinge at the shoulder, you can see the joint there, plenty of movement. Bicep swivel, double joints at the elbows, standard stuff, swivel and then the tilt on the wrist too. Same for the other side. Swivel torso, and he's also got the ab crunch, which clicks down pretty well. Up to the top of the thighs, peg up at the top of the thighs, standard stuff again. We've got the swivel up at the top of the thighs, double joints at the knees, rocking ankles, and all together, everybody, pickles for those things that Hasbro never give us. So, Drax is a good figure, definitely looks good with the new head sculpt, but yeah, it's a little samey. But then again, not a lot of people did manage to find all the figures, some didn't, but they seem to be, I think Hasbro found a big mountain of them. They seem to have been turning up in a lot of Target stores in the US. So, there we go. Let us know what you think about Drax. You buying this one again? Skipping? Love it? Hate it? Let us know. Leave a comment below. If you're brand new to the channel, click subscribe and you'll get lots of cool reviews. Funko Pop, Star Wars, Black Series, Hot Toys, all sorts of stuff we get reviewed, as well as podcasts and other stuff too. That's it for me and Drax. We shall see you for another review coming right up. Bye.